Biafra, Umunem, Nomanam, Bonde Nona, Libo, Nala Biafra. Ozimnez Garon, no Bocheta. Bocono, Gisige, Basiem Brigge. Na afugo m na anyị ga-enwere onwe anyị afugo m na mbọ anyị na-agba maka nwere onwe nna anyị ha bụ ndị lụlụ ọgụ a nna m bụ chukwuka dị n'aka so wee lụọ ya bụ ọgụ nwekwa ọtụtụ nsogbu mana ọ sọvaivụrụ ya bụ ọgụ ma n'ụbọchị taata kwa mmụnwa na-alụkwa ya bụ ọgụ Ne represent kwa nnam ne represent kwa obodo mbu Biafra na ala Cambodia o ya kam ji se ka mwetoro no ozia no bocheta kono le nyonyonyo basara ndom basara ganse alo ya bogo na ala Cambodia
Okay, so originally my name, my real name is Manuel Chukwad Makonyetika, but I make my fighting name Manu Selapak. So Manu is driving from Emmanuel, shortcut of Emmanuel is Manu. And then Selapak, in Cambodia it means entertainment, entertainer. And naturally I have that entertaining character in me. I did a lot of things in Cambodia. I was a dancer, so I'm not like, I know how to stand on the crowd anyway. I was a dancer and I did a couple of MC and I sing in public. So I like to entertain people. I like to make people laugh. My game plan is I'm gonna dribble him around. I'm gonna run around at the first round, get him a bit tired. Second round, I will give him a bit tips of what I can do with my hand. Then third round, I will finish him. And if I miss the finishing on the third round, on the fourth round, or even though we get to the final decision, I'm sure to get him very good points with my hand. That was my plan. He was telling me to play smart, to follow the game plan, because okay. we make the game plan together.
Okay. Okay.
So he was telling me to remember everything. Yeah, I did that. That's what I said here also. Just run around, make people laugh. I was entertaining, and then he got upset. Is because I studied that guy very well. I watched a couple of his fights very well. He's a very technical fighter. His best and focused technique is knee and elbow. He got like 25 fights with 18 knockouts. So, he's good. It's round two, I meant business. Yeah, round two, I throw him around like a like a sick rat. Come in with his flying knee and elbow, I block it, and then I go again. So that was the plan. So I put pressure, very, very high pressure on him that he get tired. This round I start to lose energy towards the end of second round. The weight cut still affect me at that moment. Yeah, before the fight I felt fully recovered. Then when I get in there, when I get in there, it didn't last because it's actually my body needed more. Yeah. So I skip a lot of days not eating. So I just eat only once. I still need more time to recover fully. Right. So what I eat, just digest, and I use the energy already. So I get very tired. I was very tired towards the end of the fight. Ratana was telling me to finish it. Ratana was telling me like, okay, you're looking tired. Ratana noticed he's old fighter. So he noticed, he tell me like, I have to target where to finish it. He tell me, use your hand. Go in with leg, use your hand. This is what I can remember. So he said these two things. He said, now you can finish it, you're tired. If you keep going, like entertaining people or trying to make some show, you might be out. Yeah, he told me. He told me to play. He said, stop playing, like fight. And on the second year, to play, like stop playing. Yeah, fight. He said, now I'm looking tired. So I got to go. The guy is also tired. So he tell me to put power. But he tell me to go, stop going, putting too much pressure, because putting too much pressure, I'm getting exhausted as well. So he tell me to throw one punch, like pump, but power punch. If I throw one, relax. Take your time, throw one again. So that can go to finish it. Anytime I knock him down, he get up like he took something. He get up like magic, like boom. That was my last blood punch. If the guy survived it, maybe he knocked me out. not he knocked me out, maybe I just run out of gas. Because I gave him my last power punch to him. That was my last power punch. As heavy as it can be.
Nobody tata kwa mua na lokwa ya bogo.